And so, dear ones, there are many techniques that teach gymnastics, various movements, various contortions of your mind, emotion, and body, for they teach you to use your mind to imagine new forms and shapes. They teach you to use your mind to create new emotional energies of fancy. They teach you to distort, to contort, to bend your body in many shapes. But, dear ones, these are all products of the personal mind, products of the ego self, and not the direct experience of that which exists beyond these three layers of human being. These, dear one, are techniques to exercise the mind, to build the mind, to build and reshape the mind, body, and emotions to some new experience. They have their goal, but it is not meditation. Meditation, dear one, is the transcendence of the human condition into the experience of pure, formless awareness. We say, dear one, that this fourth state is beyond the human condition, for this is the all-encompassing state of being. This state has no forms. This state has no noise, has no shape. This state, dear one, is beyond the expression of what we call human. It is beyond the thoughts of the mind, beyond the energies of the emotion, and beyond the shape and actions of the body. It is pure, empty, still, silent, and all-encompassing. It is the container in which life, as manifestation, is being experienced. And so, dear ones, the fourth state does exist in your human condition, but it is beyond the form of your human condition. For the fourth state of awareness is that which you are, that which you will always be, even after this human form leaves you. And so, dear one, as you continue along your meditation practice, you will find your experience of awareness growing. Increasing, you will find yourself becoming more and more as this formless awareness. For your mind will grow in greater silence. Your emotion will grow in greater peace and stillness. Your body will lose its feeling of heaviness. Your body will lose its feeling of solidity. Your body will come to a state of peaceful relaxation. And so, dear one, as your awareness grows, you will find yourself more and more becoming this formless awareness, and your awareness of the body will remove naturally. Your meditation will deepen, and you will lose awareness of your physical form. Do not be afraid. Do not be intimidated by this experience of surrender. Instead, trust this process and remain aware. Remain awake to the awareness that you are while allowing yourself to surrender your personal identification with this body. Allow it to disappear from your awareness. Allow your meditation to go deeper within. Then, dear one, you will notice a heightened experience of emotion, for you will begin to perceive emotion that is stronger than that which you have felt within the physical body. This is because your awareness is moving into the subtler layers of your human self, of your energetic self. And so it may appear that your emotional field has become stronger. But in truth, dear one, the emotions have remained the same. It is you yourself as this awareness that has undergone the change. For you have brought more of your awareness together into the subtler states of being. That awareness that was kept focused upon the physical material body and the material world has now been retracted back into itself, and therefore all that remains within the awareness seems to have increased in intensity. But in truth, dear one, it is simply that we are allowing our awareness to return to the source of awareness itself. We are giving up the gross manifestation of form and returning back to the most subtle. And so now, dear ones, as your emotional energies become more aware within you, remain in the state of awareness. Simply be aware. Do not focus upon these emotional energies. Do not be drawn into new desires to experience these emotional energies in new ways. Instead, stay as the awareness. For as your attention draws out into a new experience, as you feel new desires rise within you, simply withdraw them back. Withdraw your attention back into the awareness. And be this field. What you will find, dear one, is that you are processing, that you are purifying your emotional desires for various emotional experiences. And what happens, dear ones, is that the emotions begin to still, silence, unify, come into a state of oneness, come into a state of bliss. But, dear one, this is not the total bliss of self. This is simply coming into the state of peace, coming into a state of uniformity. For that which existed as our emotional energies were directed in many directions, through many desires, pulling in many various frequencies. So as we allow them to still and silence, we find them coming together in a unified state. So it may feel like greater happiness, but it is simply the emotional happiness of being as yourself. Do not desire after it, but instead let the process of meditation continue. For the bliss of your true self is far deeper than this alluring emotional experience. So do not play with your emotions. Do not be drawn into your emotion, yet always remain as the awareness with the one desire to experience yourself most fully, to experience the transcendent state most fully, to experience the fourth state of awareness most fully. Then, dear ones, as your meditation deepens one step further, the emotional body and the emotional experiences will begin to leave you. You will find yourself moving deeper into the state of mind, into the field of mind itself, which is an energetic field in which our thoughts, in which our desirous impulses first come into being. You, dear one, will perceive this as a great field of creative power, but be not lured into it. Instead, remain as the awareness itself, for you will see that the mind has the ability to create worlds within itself. You may call this your imagination while existing within the material world, the world of form, the physical body. But in the mental dimension itself, this is its reality. The mental dimension is the dimension of the foundation of manifest creation. It is where manifestation first takes birth as an idea. So you will find your subjective ideas coming into being and birthing forth new experience in yourself. It will seem real, and it is real as the expression of what this dimension of manifestation is. But in truth, dear one, it is an illusion, for it is the ever-changing form and shape being created by that which is truly real, by that which is permanent, by that which is not birthed and does not die.